I have a question for you. What do anglerfish, fireflies, and this particular nicotine plant have in common? That's right, they all glow in the dark. So, a bit more about this plant. It is a Nicotiana benthamiana plant, which is the botany world's equivalent of a lab rat. It's robust, it's easy to grow, and, well, using it has kind of just become like a scientific tradition for plant geneticists. Kind of like, you know, like a plant-based lab rat. Like a vegan-friendly lab rat. Doesn't sound very tasty, to be fair. Anyway, I'm not being sneaky with the truth here. It really does actually glow. A lot of the time when you see news headlines about like glowing rabbits and things like that, it's not actually glowing, it's just fluorescent, not luminescent. You need to shine a UV light on a glowing rabbit to actually get it to glow. If you just leave it alone in the dark, it's just a rabbit. This plant is luminescent, bioluminescent, which means that it lets off its own light. So bioluminescence is a usually natural phenomenon of light emission resulting from the oxidation of some specific substrate called a luciferin. And that is usually catalyzed by an enzyme called luciferase. Basically, luciferase cuts luciferin and light comes out. What this means is that bioluminescent organisms have to produce both the luciferin and the luciferase so that the luciferase can cut the luciferin to release the light. And this is true for any glowing creature, whether it be fireflies, anglerfish, glowworms, Nicotiana benthamiana, you name it. And out of the two, the harder thing for scientists to recreate is actually the luciferin, the substrate, because it takes many steps to get there. You need an entire genetic circuit dedicated to it, whereas luciferase is just one protein. And up until a few years ago, if you wanted to make a genetically modified organism capable of producing the luciferin, there was pretty much just one feasible option for you if you were the scientist, and that was a genetic circuit that was derived from bacteria, and that just makes bacterial luciferin. And that has been tried, but ultimately it didn't produce enough light when they put it in the plant. You could inject luciferin into the plant to make it glow brighter, but that was expensive and also toxic to the plant, so not something that was viable for long term. So then came along this paper, which published a luciferin production pathway taken from fungi, specifically the bear with me here as I fail to pronounce this. Neonothopanus nambi fungus. Neonothopanus nambi fungus. This fungal luciferin can be produced relatively easily by plants by hijacking the caffeic acid cycle, which is present in every single plant, meaning that plant geneticists can now make glowing plants like this one. If you want to see a deeper dive into the research, let me know in the comments below, because this one was really short. I've included links to the papers in the description, so you can go check out those if you want. And if you want to support the channel further, consider subscribing. I'm also going to be launching a Patreon page soon, so keep your eyes peeled for that one. And yeah, goodbye.